Oh, hello. Hi, Lester Jones here. This is a follow-up to the weathering video. This is weathering 102. As well as abrasive weathering, you want to get the character into your jacket that looks like you've worn it for a long time. So that means wrinkles and stretches and creases. All the usual stuff that jackets have after a long use. There are two ways of doing the water treatment or the shower treatment. The first one, get in the shower wearing a jacket. Make sure you're wearing other clothes so you don't mind getting wet. Alternatively, just hold the jacket in the shower, get it all nice and soaking wet, and then put it on and go across, go about your day. So I'm just gonna finish off getting this nice and soaked. Right, there we go. I'm absolutely soaking wet now, which is the ideal. You can also do this by just walking in the rain. If it's a nice heavy rain, nice and warm, don't go over regular body temperature for the water. It doesn't need to be hot. If it's hot, you can dry out the leather and it can end up stretching more than you want it, and it can end up hard and firm. You want to keep the softness in the leather without having to later apply something like Peccards or some other lotions and potions. Right, now it's all wet. There's a number of things to do. Mostly just go about your day and wait for it to dry. Depending on how warm it is and how humid, depends on how long that will take. You can pull up the sleeves. That's often a nice one to get exaggerated wrinkles. Remember, if your jacket was the perfect length when you started, pulling them up and creating wrinkles can shrink, not shrink, but pull up where the sleeves sit on your wrists. I usually get an extra half an inch to an inch on my sleeves, so they sort of touch the knuckles, or just above the knuckles, so that when I do the shower treatment, they sit just below the wrist. Don't do too much arm movement when you have them up like this, because it can stretch the material where you don't want it stretching. But you can already see now that nice wrinkles are staying in there. Other things, just massage the jacket while you're walking around or having a nice romp in the woods. Romp to non-English people can just mean a nice walk. The Temple of Doom jacket has got some nicely exaggerated wrinkle creases up the top. So again, you can just squeeze the jacket up like that and get them started and just keep repeating that. The Temple of Doom jacket I'm wearing is probably the least creased up jacket, but it does offer the personalisation. When you wet it, you know, it moulds to your shape, just becomes more personal and fits better. LC jackets don't fit perfectly. They've got large arm openings. That's the same from any vendor. So when you lift up the jacket, your arms, the jacket comes with it. Apologies for the flab. Right, so like I say, just wear it until it dries. Alternatives to wearing it is you can just get it wet, scrunch it up on the floor on a towel and get some wrinkles going. And if you want the sleeve wrinkles, just you can insert tubes or rods in them and just hook them up while it's on the floor. Again, this is great for collars because new collars usually stick up in strange ways that aren't particularly natural. So you can find a nice position for your collar, give it a squeeze, and because it's wet, it will remember that position when it dries. That's really it. I'll check back in later with any other details. Hello again. Right, so let's finish off. In the last segment, I accidentally referred to this as a top jacket. Obviously it's not. This is the Wested Legacy Last Crusade jacket. The leather's nice and soft and fairly thick, so it really lends itself to this treatment. You see the wrinkles are really staying in there. The jacket's still damp, but you know, you can see the future. The wrinkles can drop out slightly, so generally go a little bit further than you want the end product to look like. Now this treatment, different leathers react differently to this treatment. So like I say, a nice thick leather often takes the wrinkles very well, and they'll be in there for a good long time. Things lighter, wispier leathers, like maybe the Shrunken Lamb, they may not take on the wrinkles as much. The authentic lamb, that takes them on very well. The wash lamb doesn't really take them on that well, because it's quite fine leather and it's already had treatments to the washing, which gives it all the character already. A few things to say. Back to abrasive weathering. Some people like to abrase their jacket while it's wet, and this will lend a softness to the weathering, so you get more blended edges. The difficulty is, because it's wet, the underneath goes dark and you can't really see where you've weathered. So if you do choose to do that, be careful knowing exactly where you're weathering and not overdoing it. But you can do partial weathering while wet, let it dry and then finish off. That's an option. Like I say, go back with day, but maybe introduce a bit more exaggeration into your movements. So, you know, if the jacket is a little tight, you can, you know, stretch it out while it's wet. The wetter it is, the more likely it is to stretch out. And just, you know, absentmindedly, just squeeze and crunch your jacket up, adding those wrinkles, squeezing your collar. You know, it's not a one-shot deal. You know, you might have to repeat this, but generally once is enough, just to get the character in. And once the character's in there, any weathering you do becomes more naturalistic, because it's hitting the high spots that would get hit when you're, you know, going about your adventures. So yeah, that's it really. Have a good day. This has been a Lester Jones Broadcasting Corporation production. So, one very important addendum. When you get the jacket wet, depending on how it's been treated, how it's been tanned, etc., dye may or may not, you know, seep from the jacket. You may see the water in the shower go a little bit brown. But very important things to remember: don't sit on your wife's brand new sofa wearing a wet leather jacket. You may stand up and look like you're still sitting there. Again, watch for drips on pale carpets. It's negligible normally, so often best to go outside, but that's it really. Just be careful of dye transfer.